is defend his decision to end the war. No American presence there could resolve the country's own problems. Do you consider this to be sort of acknowledgement of the failure of the previously declared American mission in the country?
No, I think this is actually very, very complicated. I think Washington aims to create another civil war in Afghanistan by pulling out, in a sense that some in Washington, I call them the party of war, Republican and Democrat alike. These people wish an ongoing perpetual warfare between the U.S. trained and equipped Afghan army of Kabul versus the crazed, ideologically Wahhabi supported by Saudi Arabia that we call the Taliban. I think by pulling out, Biden actually aims to create a vacuum in which the Chinese national interest in Afghanistan would be jeopardized, mainly by extracting of just about every useful natural resources, such as minerals that are quite strategic in extending our high-tech revolution vis-a-vis China. I think in doing so, the technological growth of the Chinese economy would be slowed down. My colleagues and I believe this might be one of the long-term geopolitical strategies in the region, and of course, completely intentional and at some point possibly successful in the short term. But this vacuum is an unsustainable strategy because there are many state and non-state actors in this war-torn region. We invaded and occupied Afghanistan in less than 1 month from September 11, 2001. Of course, this was all pre-planned and pre-orchestrated years before 9/11/2001, under the pretext of capturing a CIA known asset known as Osama bin Laden. To be precise, the so-called US-led coalition forces attacked and aerially bombarded Taliban-held territories on October 7th, literally 26 days after 9/11. With the pretext that we would defeat Al-Qaeda and their host Taliban and bring freedom, I put this in quotation, freedom and democracy and women's rights to Afghanistan, all the wonderful attributes that we cherish and celebrate here in the West. What have we sowed and reaped from all this? Inadvertently or advertently, we created chaos in an already decades-long chaotic situation in Afghanistan, but we still have chaos there with possibly more to follow, in my opinion. We brought chaos to Iraq. We brought chaos to Afghanistan. We brought chaos to Syria. We brought chaos to Yemen. We brought chaos to Libya. The case can be made that nothing was really improved by our foreign adventurism, and that things have actually gotten worse, much worse. Out of chaos comes terrorism. In the name of fighting terrorism, we have exponentially created more terrorists. Terrorists love chaos where there is a vacuum, and terrorists love a vacuum. The result, terrorism grows and thrives and becomes more organized. There is some preliminary evidence of certain factions of ISIS being present in Afghanistan and quite possibly compete with Taliban and the Afghan National Army of Kabul. So I don't think this is an acknowledgement of defeat whatsoever. Now, suffice it to say, all empires, starting with Alexander the Great, fell in the mountains of Hindu Kush, which would be today's Afghanistan. Shift forward 2,000 years after that, or longer, 2,500 years, the British fell there. They were defeated in Afghanistan, and as late as the 1980s, it was the Soviet Union's term to be defeated there, and now it's our turn. But I think Biden's pullout is a whole lot more strategic than we are led to believe by our mainstream media. I think there's a nefarious agenda in this pullout. Now, you know, to use the Occam's razor, which is the principle in physics, sometimes the easiest explanations are the most accurate. So let's say we got defeated. Let's say this is another Vietnam scenario in 1975, where we pulled out, the North Vietnamese armies were coming down, which in a sense would be like the Taliban now. And how could we forget those scenes where Vietnamese were trying to get on board U.S. helicopters on the roof of our embassy in Saigon. And then these other images of literally pushing helicopters into the ocean from U.S. aircraft carriers. Could we see anything like that? Those were Life magazine. There was a magazine called Life magazine back then. Probably your audience may not remember. That captured these photos and essentially demonstrated our defeat in Vietnam. Could this be the same situation? Maybe, maybe not. In Iraq, we pulled out in the deep of the night under President Obama. In this case, President Biden was even saying we will leave on 9/11. We went into this country to defeat Taliban. Not 20 years later, we are leaving on the horrible commemoration of 9/11, 20 years later on that day. So they went ahead and shifted it to August 31st. But I think our foreign policy in many cases could be reason to be a failed foreign policy in this region, in this war-torn region. And in my thinking and in my analysis, this could all be pre-planned and orchestrated in order to bring maximum chaos, in order to make it difficult for Chinese government and Chinese companies to not be able to implement their contracts. Some of these contracts are 100 years old with Afghanistan.
Alexandria.
In that sense, slowing down the Chinese economy and you know, pull a geopolitical trick here.
Yeah. Alexandria, Biden has once again pledged to evacuate Afghan interpreters who have been employed by the U.S. and its allies and now fear retaliation from the Taliban if the U.S. is withdrawing its troops. Do you think Biden will follow through on his promise?
Well, we never really pull out of any country we go in. You know, just to give you an example, we have the largest embassy. We have the largest U.S. embassy in the world in the Green Zone region of Baghdad. And in the case of Kabul and Afghanistan, we had major bases that we have pulled out of now. Bagram Air Base comes to mind. But we have literally supplied the Afghan army to the teeth and the bone with weapons and all sorts of advanced weaponry and armament. So I don't think we will really pull out. There might be a remnant of an expeditionary force, special forces perhaps, stationed in Afghanistan for asymmetrical warfare with Taliban that will be coming in. But in the case of interpreters and all these people that have collaborated with us, I think we will stick to our word. I think we will pull these people out. But I think this will be just the beginning of a new conflict in which many sides will be present. Much
yeah,
like
but
we have special...
But what about the Afghan interpreters?
What
about saving Afghan interpreters? Do you think he will fulfill his promise?
I think so. I think for most part, especially the highly valued assets of CIA being some of these interpreters, they will be evacuated out. But like I said, much like Syria, we will have a presence of, in my opinion, in my estimate, in my analysis, and in my forecast, we will have, like I said, like in Syria, we will have around 400 to 600 special forces operatives, as was the case in Syria. We will have probably the same thing in Afghanistan, in different parts of Afghanistan that are strategic to us. But in the case of interpreters and people who have collaborated with us, I think Biden will stick to his word, just like we stuck to our word when we lost in Vietnam and many Vietnamese people were brought to America, and in particular my home state of California, and in particular Southern California, where we have a vibrant Vietnamese community. So I think probably in the states of Michigan, where there's a large Muslim community, some of these Afghans will probably be settled there or otherwise, but I think they will be used later in this conflict. I don't think they'll be retiring anytime soon.